but distance is what, Ra?
0, sir.
Now here they are asking, displacement of an object may be zero even if the distance covered is not zero, they are asking. Suppose he is traveled from A to B. Now again he reaches back to the A. Then what will happen, Ra El Mukil? He is coming to the initial position only. So as we know, he came to the
position.
So by that time, what is happening? Distance covered by the body is not zero. But what is the displacement, Ra? He reached to the initial position and final position is same.
Zero, sir.
The displacement. Devarshini, displacement will become
zero.
But distance will never become zero. So assertion is true. Understanding now, reason. Let us come to the reason. So why it is displacement will become zero, guys? Because displacement is the shortest distance between the initial and the final position. So the shortest distance between the initial position and final position. Now, if the body will come to the initial position only, means final position and initial position will become same. Then displacement will become zero. So now reason is also true and assertion is also true. So now why the displacement of the object may be zero? Because always displacement means what? It is the shortest distance between the initial and final position. Yes or no? Please respond, Pradosh.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So now what's the correct answer? A, B, C, D. What is the correct answer? Why the displacement will become zero? Because displacement means what? Always the displacement means the shortest distance between the initial position and final position. Yes or no, guys?
Option A.
Option A. Because the displacement means always the distance between the initial position and final position. That is why
initial position and the final position.
Sometimes the displacement may become zero, even though if the distance covered is not zero, because the body is reached to the, again, back to the initial position. Understanding? So initial position is equals to final position, then the displacement will become zero. Yes or no? Yes.
Sure.
Next. 35th question. As we know, our cars, we have a two kinds of meters. What is that? Both I have taught you. One is speedometer, next one is odometer.
Speedometer.
So, speedometer gives you the speed at that moment, whatever the speed of your vehicle at a particular time. That is called as speedometer. So, speedometer, what is the unit, Ra? Anybody? So, what is the unit of speedometer? So, speedometer.
Kilometer per hour.
Kilometer per hour. What is that? Kilometer per hour. Now, you can take here the odometer. Odometer unit is what? Kilometers only. Correct or not? So, now they are saying speedometer of a car measures the instantaneous speed of the car. Is it right or wrong? Instantaneous.
True, sir.
Yes or no? True, it is. Because at that particular time, whatever the speed of your car, that is what it is shown by the speedometer. Esra, Monish, Pradosh, Laksha? Yes. Tamil sir. That is. So, it is true.
Yes, sir.
So, the speedometer always will shows the instant speed or the speed at that particular given period of time. Means, suppose when you are traveling now, at this moment, whatever the speed of your car will shown by the speedometer. So that is what the unit is, kilometer per hour. So it is true. Next one, reason. Can anybody read reason? Jayavarshini? What is the reason?
Yes, sir.
Yes, read.
Average speed is equal to the total distance covered by an object divided by the total time taken.
Yes, what is the average speed formula, guys? Average speed formula. Total distance traveled divided by total time taken. So it is true or not? It is true. Is it, are you finding any connection between them? This is talking about average speed. This is talking about speedometer. Do you find, are you finding any connection between them? Maitreyan? Adarshan? No.
No, sir.
So there is no connection between them. So what is the correct answer? What is the correct answer?
B.
Option B. Because this is talking about the the second statement is talking about the average speed and the first statement is talking about the speedometer. So both statements are correct, but there is no connection between them. So what is the correct answer? Option B is the correct answer. Okay, Ra?
B.
Yes. Next. Next one. 36. When a firefly hits a bus, when a firefly means what? Nighttime, that bioluminescence or living organisms. Do you know that fireflies, guys?
Yes,
nighttime, they can produce the light. When they are traveling, if it is a darkness, they will produce the light. Yes or no? Monish, have you heard? Fireflies, we can say. Fireflies are called as bioluminescence living organisms. What we should call? Bioluminescence. Remember, that is also important in life. Bioluminescence means which can are living organisms which can synthesize the light. Understanding means a biological chemical energy will converting into light energy. They are called as examples. So two examples we can say under bioluminescence. One is fireflies and another one is anglerfish. What is that? GK it is. Anglerfish. Remember, these are the two things which can produce, they synthesize their light when they are during traveling from one place to another place during a darkness. That is. Now, when a firefly hits a bus, each of them exerts the same force. Is it yes or no? As we know, it is independent of mass. Is it yes,
so suppose
if I will apply the force of 10 newtons on Prados, then even though Prados is smaller or bigger, doesn't matter. He also will exert, say, how much force on me? He also exert how much force on me? Same 10 newton force. Because as we know, action is equals to minus reaction.
Opposite.
So, size of the body doesn't matter. Whatever the force I'm exerting on the another object, that object also will exert same force on me. So now, when a firefly hit a bus, each of them exert the same force. Yes or no? Yes, it is true. Guys, because action is equals to what? Minus reaction. Understand, Ram?
Minus reaction.
Now, fireflies has more mass as compared to wind seals. Is it true? Fireflies having more mass?
No, sir. False, sir. No.
So they are having very less mass. They are extremely small creatures. Yes or no? They are extremely very small creatures there. So it is false. So what is the correct answer, Ra? What is the correct answer?
Assertion true, reason false.
Yes, assertion is true and reason is the false. So, are you understand Maitreya now? Jayavarshini, Laksha?
That
is. So, when a fireplace hits a bus, as we know, mass is independent of the understanding. Action is equals to opposite reaction. Newton's third law will say, body size and mass doesn't matter. If you are applying 1 newton force, that body is also will apply same 1 newton force on you. But effect will be based upon the mass and resistance force of them. Do you understand, Ra? Suppose I will hit very hardly the wall, then what will happen, Ra? You will get pain or wall will get the pain? You will get the pain or wall will get the pain? Because I will get the pain. Because we are living organisms, as we know, wall are much stronger than us. But whatever the force you are exerting, same force the wall will exert on your hand. Suppose I will hit slowly, you will never feel that much pain. If you hit much faster, more pain. Yes or no? Because if when you are applying more force, wall also will exert the same equal amount of force on you so that our hand will get injured. Yes or no, Monish? Yes, that is. So, option C is the correct answer. Next, this is already, we know this. This is even while I'm teaching, I have shown you this image also. So, Newton's third law of motion explains the two forces, namely action and reaction, coming into action when the two bodies are in contact with each other. So, these two forces are called as always act on the same body, always act on the different bodies, and have same magnitude and direction, act on either body at normal to each other. So, as I said, Newton's third law is acting always how many bodies, Jayavarshini? Always how many bodies? Always how many bodies? It will act on always how many bodies?
Two bodies.
two bodies, so single body. So we are not like a, we are not like Vikram, that the film, one side Romo, one side Chari, one side Avatar, that we cannot correct. So because action and reaction, action should be shown by one body and reaction should be given by another body. So Newton's third law, if you want to prove Newton's third law, is always how many bodies is required? Two bodies is required. So action will be takes place by one body and reaction will be takes place by another body, and action and reaction is always same direction or opposite direction? Same direction or opposite direction?
Opposite direction.
Opposite direction to each other. So what is the correct answer, Ra? Maitreyan, Adarshan, so always they will act on the different bodies in opposite directions. Understand? Very good. That is, so that is what you have to remember. So always the force, the Newton's third law, action and reaction will act on opposite bodies. Very good. Next one. So this is as well known that a rocket, a large volume of gases produced by the combustion of fuel, is allowed to escape through the tail nozzle in the downward direction with a tremendous speed and makes the rocket move upward. What do you mean by tremendous language? Let me see how many of you know language. What do you mean by tremendous? Elamukil, Jayvarshini, Adarshan, Tamil Selvan, what do you mean by tremendous? Tremendous means extremely large. Understanding? So tremendous is a tremendous person, means extremely grateful. He's a tremendous person, means like he's a very extraordinary person. Like the tremendous speed means extremely high speed. Okay, so that is the meaning of tremendous. So tremendous speed and makes the rocket to move upward. Which principle is followed in this take off the rocket? Moment of inertia? No, moment of inertia is not. Next. Newton's first law or Newton's law of gravitation or Newton's what is the
conservation of momentum.
Understanding? Conservation of momentum. Or else we can say action is equals to what? If there is no conservation of momentum, action is equals to reaction. So what is it will come? See, this one will come under two things. One is conservation of momentum, and also it is what? Newton's third law also. Yes or no?
Third law.
Newton's third law. Understand? Because yes, Newton's third law, action is equals to reaction. So usually it will come under conservation of momentum, they have given here. So conservation of momentum is the correct answer. That's all. Because what is the conservation of momentum here in this case formula? Can you say the conservation of momentum before launching and which is equals to conservation of momentum after launching? Yes or no, guys? Means the conservation of momentum of gases, which is equals to momentum of the rocket. Yes or no, Elamukil? Yes. So whatever the speed and mass of the gases will come down, which is equals to what, Ra? The speed and mass of the rocket. That is what both are equal. That is why rocket will go upwards. That is what you should call, Ra? Conservation of momentum. What is the principle? Conservation of momentum. Law of conservation of momentum. Very good. Let me see this question, who will answer. Which of the following figures correctly represents uniform motion of a moving object? Uniform motion. Uniform motion also.
Option D, sir.
Yes. Option D. Uniform motion. Pradosh.
Sir, option A, sir.
Option A. Uniform motion. Understand? So uniform motion means what? It is the linear graph always. Yes or no? So uniform motion means linear graph. How many times I should say? Uniform motion means what?
Linear graph.
Linear graph. Understand? So uniform motion indicate what? Linear graph. Linear. So option A is the correct answer. Yes or no, Ra? That is. Next. This is stationary. Which of the following graphs shows the object should be stationary? Stationary. Stationary, guys.
Option D.
Option D. Option D, not. Acceleration will never come on velocity.
Option B, sir.
Stationary. Stationary means it is in rest. Yes or no?
Option B, sir.
Yes. Stationary means it is in rest, position and time. Be very careful. So here also body is moving with a constant velocity. Yes or no? body is moving with a constant velocity.
Yes,
now here uniform velocity, here uniform motion. Now this one also what? Acceleration. It is a zero acceleration. Acceleration is zero. It is moving with a constant acceleration. Same. Like suppose, actually constant acceleration won't be. Constant velocity will be there. Yes or no? But here acceleration should not come. Velocity only should come. But I don't know. Okay. But okay, here they are asking stationary object. So stationary means the body should be in what? The body is at rest. So rest. It is not moving anywhere. So what is the correct answer? Option B is the correct answer. Very good. Next, this is biology. So meristematical tissue it is. So label the correct following diagram in correct order from the options given below. So first one is apical meristem. So first one is apical meristem, second one is intercalary meristem, and third one is what?
Intercalary.
Lateral meristem. Understanding. So lateral meristem. So first one is what? First one is apical meristem, second one is intercalary meristem, and third one is what? Lateral meristem. Yes,
lateral meristems.
That is very good. Yes, next, which connective tissue join muscles to bones? They are asking. Muscles to bones. Somebody will be the mediator between the muscles and bones. What is that called? Tendons. That is direct question. Yeah, this is the direct question. So directly you have to remember. So the connective tissues is called as tendons, which will barricade between the muscles and the bones. Okay, next, this is the structure of what? The type of muscles shown in the diagram are likely to be found in the stomach. So what is this one?
Smooth muscles,
straightened muscles, cardiac muscles, or none of the above. They are not the straightened muscles or even cardiac muscles. So what they are called as? Smooth muscles. By seeing the structure itself, you can answer. Yes or no? They are the Tamil Selvan. They are the smooth muscles. Yes, that is. Next, which type of permanent tissue helps in storing food in plants? Already we have studied this question just now.
Parenchyma.
Reason assertion, this question came or not? Yes or no? Yes, parenchyma, sir.
Yes,
present in the leaves, which will help in storage of food. That is most important. Parenchyma. Understand? Next, this one. This is epithelium. Epithelium. Which type of epithelium is illustrated in the given figure? Which type of epithelial? It is what?
Simple squamous epithelium,
cuboidal epithelium, or columnar epithelium. What is this? It is
simple squamous epithelium.
This question also came. Simple. So, yeah, simple squamous epithelium. Present in where, guys? It is present in where? Skin. Yes or no? Squamous epithelium is present in skin. That is what the question came already in reason assertion. Yes or no, Ra? Yes, that is. So already we have been answered. Where it is that? This question only, I think. Where is that question? Yes, this one. So squamous epithelium present in where? Surface of skin. And cuboidal epithelium will be present in the where? Body organs like salivary tube, salivary glands, kidneys, and etc. Okay, so let it be. So this is all about it. Now already 7 o'clock, we have to get ready for the school. Thank you, all of you. We'll stop with here, then we'll continue that. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.